This is a case of 6-year-old young girl with repeated attacks of UTIs. UTI is common in young girls and can be easily treated with antibiotics within 1 week without any major complication or side effect. However, there are some congenital abnormalities that can cause repeated attacks of UTIs, like vesicoureteric reflux or ureteroseal, like in this case. These must be ruled out with the help of ultrasound. This is the right kidney. This is normal. No hydronephrosis, no stone seen in the kidney. This is the left kidney. The left kidney shows hydronephrosis and dilated ureter. The kidney is normal in size, 9.4 cm, and cortex is also normal. This is 9 mm. Echogenicity and CM distinction is normal. The renal prolactin system contains clear fluid, no debris seen in it. The dilated ureter must be traced to find the cause of the hydronephrosis. This is ureter. This is upper. Now this is the mid ureter. We can trace the ureter up to the distal level. And no significant cause of obstruction seen in the ureter. This is the urinary bladder. This is well descended. Wall thickness is normal. This is filled with clear fluid. The distal end of the left ureter shows a balloon-like intravesical swelling and bulging. This is of size 22 × 8.3 mm. This is ureteroseal, a congenital anomaly that is present in about 1 in 1000 births. A ureteroseal happens when the end of the ureter that enters the unibladder don't dwell properly and swells like a balloon. The swollen area can block the flow of urine. As we can see, the dilated left distal third ureter. It can cause infection, UTIs, and when untreated, chronic reflux, obstruction, and infection can cause renal damage. The treatment depends on patient age, health, and extent of the blockage. Patient may be given antibiotics to prevent infections. Stents may provide short-term relief by placing drains in the ureter. Surgery can be done. The surgical procedure is usually successful in 90 to 95% of the time. Thanks for watching the video.